co-ed students running from? They're not. They're running to the world's toughest competition in town. Today, we're coming from the exotic consumer paradise at Universal Studios on the majestic shores of landlocked Orlando, Florida. Witness collegiate chaos as the frats and sororities take on the dorm queens. It's the classic battle of Greeks versus Geeks on this special edition of MXC Almost Live. And now, two guys who always get an A for effort, Kenny Blankenship and Vic Romano.
Vic. Hey, Vic.
There you go.
Sorry, I'm late. I had to drive three hot college chicks home. What a night.
Oh, spending the evening with a couple of eager co-eds preparing for today's competition, eh, Ken?
No. I'm talking about hot college chicks, and they're everywhere. Orlando's crawling with them.
Well, of course they are, Ken. It's MXC Almost Live.
Is that product in your hair?
Sorry? Oh, well, yes. Thank you for noticing. It's a little dab. Actually, it is tasseled in the manner of an honorary doctorate. Like myself, a man of letters, huh?
What, like a mailman?
Mailman, let's go to Gee.
Gee here. Regrettably, I'm on double secret probation for an earlier misunderstanding, so I'll be forced to watch today's proceedings from this high-tech observation cell. I am under a gag order, but Gee never gags, so I can tell you it involves two co-eds, a Moroccan gymnast, and a horribly stained pommel horse. And now, for the games, we first start with upper division wall bangers, then extra credit course of sinkers and floaters. You'll next make the grade with window pane, and finally graduate to log drop. I only wish I could be there to feel the pain of every co-ed. Let's go to the student quad and our skipper.
Greetings, impressionable minds. Question, how many of you think the university experience is ample preparation to ensure a successful life in the real world? Show hands, now. Well, you're wrong. The only things you'll glean from your college experience are several well-crafted beer bongs, student loans you'll never repay, and a variety of STDs. Kevin, Albie, do you agree?
No.
I'm thinking.
But please, take your seat.
Oh, yeah.
Save that for your future husband.
Yeah. Captain, if I may, if you taught at the university, I'd major in captain studies, and I'd stay after and do extra credit just for you.
What a kisser!
Easy, settle. Now, if you will follow my hand as I gesture skyward, in MXC's ongoing commitment to safety, the Orlando Air Militia will now do a flyover and release their payload of complimentary multicolored prophylactics. Chopper one, drop your load now. Now. Chopper two, spray your load now. Let's go!
Today, the historic competition of Greeks versus Geeks. Right now, we're going to take an extremely close-up look at the leaders of today's teams. First up, the Geek team captain, a man who revolutionized skateboarding. He is unquestionably one of the world's most famous athletes. Known as the Birdman, he is none other than Tony Hawk.
All right, thanks, Vic. I got a message from my team, and that's no more Mr. Nice Guy. The Geeks have been laughed at, scoffed at, wedgied, ridiculed, trash canned. I speak from experience. Today, the Geeks rise up and fight back. Be warned, Greek.
Oh, tough fighting words from the Birdman, Ken.
Hey, Tony.
Yeah.
Almost says what?
What?
Kenny. Kenny, that's enough. How about a little respect?
Hey, forget him. Let's go to the Greek team leader. She's hot. And one of the hottest hot snowboarding chicks in the world. She's won 5 X Games and is considered the bad girl of extreme sports. Give it up for Tara, the terrorizer, Dakides. You are hot.
Thanks, Kenny. Somebody tell Tony that his team of jackpipes are going down. My Greeks may not get the best grades, but they know how to party and win. Yeah. So, Geeks, don't break your pocket protectors.
Oh, it is getting ugly down there. The Greeks getting all up in the Geeks' business.
Yes, indeed, Geek.
Huh? Oh, anyway, look at them going back and forth, Ken.
Almost says sorry.
Sorry, Ken? Anyways, I didn't hear you. Look at that, Ken. There you've seen it. Tony Hawk throwing down the double bird. It is on, my friend. There's the ceremonial napalm, and we are off the wall bangers. Each wall has only one passable door. Choose the wrong door, and you get slammed. Now let's go down to Tony Hawk, who's giving the Geeks a pep talk.
So, bunch of walls. You want to treat each one like an open door. Find the portal to freedom.
Geek power.
Find some closed doors, but you just have to break through them.
Yeah!
Let's do it.
All right, there you have it.
Oh, Vic, look, a hostage situation.
No, Ken, actually, a few of our collegians overindulged in last night's orientation mix, and their eyes are still a little light sensitive. And now, the captain's most promising new cadet, Major Babe.
Let's get it on.
And first up for the Greeks.
I got shotgun.
That's fifth-year sophomore Matt Hayden. He's an Oxford road trip scholar.
He can party, drive, and study all at the same time.
Oh, it hits hard, Ken. Looks like he landed on his alma mater. Let's take another look at that. Ken, take us through the replay.
Put it right here, Vic. I think he left some of his knowledge right on the door.
I think you might be right.
See, it's smeared right there.
Indeed it is. Let's go down to get LaDouche.
That road tripping runs in my family. My great-grandfather strapped on a pony keg and a pony express. That day, the mail didn't get through. In the 70s, my dad fit an entire side-by-side in the back of his Vega wagon. I'm serious. Me and you, road trip. Let's go.
Yes, I want to go with you. I do.
And first up for the Geeks, Chaz Deffren.
I was born with an extra nard.
He's majoring in testicular studies at Ball State.
I think he just lost his extra nard.
Oh, looks like Geek Coach Tony Hawk is clearly disappointed. Also, we might have an injury, but our medical team is on site.
That's pretty deep. Just kind of creepy out, a guy touching you. How about here? That really bugged me.
That's creepy.
What stinks?
Next up, Junior Amanda Boatman. She's a member of the Stepford sorority and studies ancient Latin tongues.
Yeah, her tongue is ancient history right here. Hey, Vic, remember the triplets I was in the jacuzzi with last night?
Yes, kind of remember that. Yeah.
She's half of them.
Indeed. Well, let's take another look at that again as she walks off the course. You can see right there. Nice move through the first door.
Hey, Vic, is that her twin?
Yeah, Kenny, we're doing the replay.
Oh, yeah. Look, she soiled her underwear.
Great observation as usual, Ken. Next up for the Geeks, Tad Tripe from Cal Arts and Crafts.
I got your money shot right here.
Known for his massive student aid package.
Oh,
let's take another look at that, Ken.
Yeah, look right here. He's careful not to land on his assets.
Right you are, Ken. Ouch. And here he is with his roommate, Dennis Swain.
It's nice and warm on my back. We're together forever.
Dismount. Kenny reminds me of the lifelong bonds I made with my college chums.
Almost as what?
What?
I've seen my sister naked.
Oh, here's another member of the Stepford sorority. It's Dittla Boatman. She's through the first door.
It's the other half of the triplet I was in the hot tub with.
Good for you, Ken.
Oh, now she's flat-chested.
Next up, Kerem Hussein.
I've got a freezer full of cats in my basement.
Majoring in boy sauces at the Jeffrey Dahmer Culinary Institute.
Oh, yes.
Goes head first to the first welcome.
Yeah, all his classes take place in the Hannibal Lecter Hall.
Right you are. You can see his shirt there. Acts like a fishing lure to his unsuspecting young projects. And it looks like he just might make it all the way through. Head first, Ken! And he's done it! Unbelievable!
That's how you make it!
Let's go down to Gip.
Oh, you did a great job. Yeah. Give us a blow-by-blow, please.
Well, it's pretty tough, but did you see the first door? I ripped through it like a human skin.
Oh, that's exciting and scary.
Yeah. I'm having a party at my folks' basement. I'd love to have you for dinner. What are you, about 120?
That's
about 20 minutes per pound. Why don't you come around 2? That way
to.
I can eat by 6.
And here's Teddy Izzard from the Dame Edna University.
Completely disoriented.
He's in the cross-dressing Sigma Bi.
Man, he just went through a solid door.
That's right, Ken. His hormones are raging.
Wow.
Completely out of control.
This guy's ruining our stuff.
Just a rigorous competitor, Ken.
He got his dress all dirty.
Clearly a reaction to the estrogen. Let's take another look now. You can see here he starts off one of his trademark Pilates moves. Heading right for that door, 6 inches of solid oak.
With a mahogany veneer and a rich Danish oil finish.
Oh, wow, Ken, how'd you know that?
I'd read it in this magazine.
Of course, showing the same intensity employed at the semi-annual Victoria's Secret sale. Next up, prolific widow and mother of 17.
Your intestine is wrong.
Little Higby, she's an ecology major, hopes to Monday clean up the river dance.
Oh!
And she's down hard, Ken.
Oh, she's so dainty. I hope she wasn't hurt.
Right you are. Lynn, of course, widowed for the 14th time, recently returning to college for a good life. Let's take another look at that on replay, Ken. And, of course, Lynn and Aries and a natural redhead.
Yeah, and right here, Vic, you know what they say? Red on the head, fire in the hole.
Sorry, Ken. Kenny! Earlier, Gip had a chance to chat with this dainty rose of the Emerald Isle. Here's what she had to say.
Oh, you're so pretty. Were you ever a model?
Oh, no, not me.
Were you ever remarried?
No, I couldn't.
Oh,
never.
Oh, I love redheads. You have such soft skin.
Thank you.
Would you turn around so I could see you?
Of course,
all the
just
way
don't
around.
Touch me. The touch of a man gives me the wind.
Oh, Irish Spring.
Oh, thank you.
Next up for Alpha Chi Sigma.
It's just a cold sore.
That's Donna Legion. Her free spirited sorority love life. A real sore spot.
Uh-oh. I think she's going to go all the way, Vic.
I think you might be right.
And
yes. A triple penetration, and she's done it, Ken.
Wow, she's used to that.
I think you're right, and the crowd goes wild. She's just scored for the Greeks, and it is now 1-0.
Look at that, Vic. She's itching so bad, she's trying to shake the sores off.
It's a shame.
Have a
And here's Damian Beelzebub, a sophomore from Haiti State, credited with forming an unholy student union.
Yeah, they have 666 members.
Right you are, Ken. And look at him there.
I call on you.
Look, Vic, he's obsessed. Oh, yeah.
Where are you?
Clearly having trouble there. Oh, getting angry. Can't get through that glass door.
He's going to start throwing up pea soup.
Right you are, Ken. Tony Hawk clearly disappointed. That's our MXC Impact replay.
Look, Vic, if you play it backwards, you can hear a satanic message.
Watch Spike TV.
Wow, creepy stuff, Ken. Well, it looks like the geeks have cracked the door open, but the Greeks went through too, and it's all tied up at 1-1.
Yeah, more from the beautiful exotic shores of Orlando after this.
Indeed.
Captain here on the Orlandotron. When we return, our collegians take a full load on sinkers and floaters. Then, a rare appearance by world-famous P-Lander Z. All this and more when MXC Almost Live continues. And I should know, I'm the captain. From Orlando, Florida, MXC Almost Live is back for more collegiate banging as the Greeks battle the Geeks.
Well, Kenny, it's been a real battle between the geeks and Greeks, huh?
Yeah, Vic.
Wow, it has just been totally back and forth competition. Kenny, I can't help but notice you've done something with your hair.
Hmm? Yeah, I used a little product in my hair, too. Now I'm smart.
Kenny, it is not the tasseled hair that makes you smart. It is what's underneath.
Oh, I'll take it off then.
Okay, good. Thank you, Kenny. Yeah. Speaking of that, it's time for Sinkers and Floaters, where contestants skip across the slippery stones without getting a mouthful of septic sludge. Let's hear what the team captains are telling their teams.
Stay on the floaters, and if you get a sinker, you're in the toilet. Floaters.
Sinkers and floaters, this one's ours.
Well, the stage is set, and we are underway with Major Babe.
Get it on.
First up, future diabetic Jim Saland. He's currently enrolled at the College of Hemorrhoidal Studies.
I mean anorexia!
Wow. Who's anorexia? Why did he beat her up?
Good question, Ken.
Here we
go. Oh, Jim goes down floor!
Man, it's during a tidal wave.
Right to our Ken. The crowd got a good rinsing. And as Jim gets to his feet, let's take another look. You can see right here, he starts off with a half arbuckle into a full Gleason, but he tried a weeping Louis Anderson and couldn't pull it off. Next up from Carnegie Mellon's is Kimber Swallow. She's a sorority house practical joker, loves a good gag.
Can't see my feet!
Well, she has feet?
She claims to, Ken. There she goes, she's off.
Uh-huh.
Moving nicely. Oh! She's down. Big reaction from the crowd there from Tara.
Oh, man.
Kimber trying to make her way out of the...
Oh, look at that. She's got two black eyes.
Kenny, let's go to the replay. You see right there, she just misjudged that second step. Kenny, what are you doing?
I got a better replay.
Kenny, that's not a proper replay.
Yeah, you're right. It needs music.
Woohoo! Kenny, let's go down the gym.
Well, anything you want to ask me about my breasts?
No, I want to talk about your studies.
Oh, come on. Who wants to talk about that? Ask me about my breasts.
No, I want to hear about your education.
Oh, come on. Look at them. Look, they're crashing into each other. Isn't that fun?
Oh, Gip is horrified.
Now they're sagging. Oh, I slept off a nipple.
Next up from the Catholic University, Our Lady of Guilt and Shame, it's Gary Schultz.
I borrowed this mouthpiece.
Gary, of course, a Golden Gloves champion.
Yeah, he was suspended for constantly boxing the bishop.
Oh, he took one to the chin right there, Ken.
Oh, man.
Here's pharmaceutical student Benny Ford.
This is for my mom!
Studying on a clinical trial scholarship.
Whoa.
He's had over 400 drugs tested on him, Ken.
Oh! You see the banana hammock he's wearing?
Indeed, I did, Ken.
Now I know where he hides his drugs.
I think you might be right. Let's take another look at this as he struggles his way out of the septic sludge. Seems to be in good spirits.
Oh, I think he's testing some drugs right now.
I think you might be right.
I hope he was wearing his cup.
Let's take another look at that. You can see him there trying a full apothecary into a side effect. Oh, and he's down on a Johnson & Johnson.
Warning, this event may cause nadular swelling and discomfort.
Next up for the geeks is Fitch Abercrombie. He's captain of the J. Crew team.
I'm hooked on phonics.
There we go. He takes off.
Starts off with a Sean John.
Into a fashionable FUBU. A Hilfinger. A hot reverse Versace.
Oh.
And he scores one for the geeks, Ken. Go. Let's take another look. You can see right there he hit two sinkers. Still makes it across. What a natty and well-appointed performance, Ken.
Smashing run. I can't wait to tell you all about it. First of all,
I'm sorry we don't have time to talk to you.
What do you mean you can't talk to me? There's a smashing... No, you will talk to me. You will talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me.
All right, then tell me how you did it.
Well, I started my left foot, then the right, of course. And you can't talk.
Next up, Harvard honor student Camille Toe.
I just made a hasty pudding. Yeah.
Camille's carrying a labia major with a labia minor.
Something fishy about that major. I can't put my finger on it.
All right, you're right, Ken. She squeezed herself a little thin there, and she's into the fluid. What a shame.
Oh, no.
And next up for the geeks, it's Lester Wayne. He's a student government employee. Ooh, Until Tara gives
her
opinion.
Doesn't matter what I say, you're going to overdub my voice.
What was that? Overdub what? Yes. What is that, McDonald?
You should have overdubbed his run.
Right, you are, Ken. Let's take another look. You can see here, he starts off. Doesn't last long, and he's right there in the safety sludge. And what is it, Ken?
That's used bog water from the Pac-10.
Outstanding. And here's Robert Neville. He's an Omega Man.
Damn dirty ape.
Robert's the very last brother in his fraternity.
Yeah, the rest died from a biological disease from the frat laundry hamper.
Right there, Ken. But he has made it all the way across. Let's go down to Gimp and find out how it went.
What happened to your brothers, huh?
They all died, but I was inoculated. Look, right here. I'll show you the needle hole.
I think it should speak for itself. Talk to Gimp.
And here's Marvin Jensen. He's president of the Radio Control Club at MIT. My batteries are low.
Yeah, at this moment, he's actually being controlled by his roommate via satellite uplink.
There he goes, moving across nicely. Oh, looks like his signal got jammed, Ken. His servo's locked up on him.
I hope he's waterproof.
I hope you're right. Here's serial mimer Marcel Bundy from the Green River College.
Hold my gun.
Hey, no time.
Marcel keeps his victims inside a fake box.
Oh, look, he's breaking against the wind.
Bet you are. Oh, he's down, and that's our MXC Impact Replay.
See right here? He's doing a leaning lamppost. And then he's just miming excruciating pain.
Right you are, Ken. Next up, Kevin Connors from the Cesar Chavez School of Revisionist History.
I'm filled with white guilt. Yes. Cesar Chavez. I love that, Sarah.
There
I go. Especially with dark meat chicken.
Right you are, Ken. There he goes, moving across nicely. Looks like the Geeks have scored. I don't know, Ken. Let's take a look at that again. From this angle. Looks like he might have stepped out. But the judges are giving it to him, Ken.
Hey, sir.
Well, the Geeks still score, and here's George Testopoulos.
Oopa!
He's the president of the only pure Greek fraternity, Ken.
Yeah, they're known for their big, hairy members.
Right, the guys are pretty good size, too, and look at that! The Greeks have scored as well.
Chalk one up for the Greeks.
So, we end up in a tie with the Greeks and Geeks both scoring twice. When we come back, it's a sinkers and floaters septic runoff, Ken.
Yeah. Don't forget about the hot triplet twins.
So there you have it after two rounds, Greeks versus Geeks, and it's all tied up at 3-3.
When MXC Almost Live returns, better pull the drapes, because we're going to get busy with window pane and P-Lander Z. Got it, dorm stain? MXC Almost Live is back from Orlando, Florida, as the battle of the frat snobs and the dorm knobs continues.
So you're proud of your little derelict crew, you know?
Absolutely.
The dropouts, the trustafarians.
Yep.
All right.
Look at me, I'm a dropout.
So it's not all about physical. But yeah, of course, you know, the Greeks.
It's not all about physical?
Yeah.
I think it's all about physical. Getting through that wall is nothing but muscle, and the Greeks have the muscle.
Yeah, that's how you guys always resort to violence. Is that how it is?
What?
She's hot.
Huh? Well, certainly no love lost between those two team leaders, eh, Ken?
Woohoo! Man, Captain and I had a great time last night.
Well, the captain said he was going to stay in and watch Lou Dobbs.
Huh? Well, he lied, I guess.
Well, why would he lie?
I don't know. He just blew you off.
Big evening planned for us.
Yeah, we partied. We went trolling for chicks in Orlando.
Hey, good looking. I'll be back to pick you up later.
Yeah, I gave him some of my best pickup lines.
Hey, sweetheart, looks like it's cold out here.
Hey, I'm new in town. Can you direct me to your apartment?
No way.
Toss my salad. Oh.
That one always works.
Guys, I didn't know those girls were with you.
And then he got kicked out of a bar.
Kenny!
That's when I dropped the camera and ran away.
Well, Kenny, it sounds like you had a really good time.
Yeah, what'd you do, Vic?
Oh, you know, just kicked around the motel room.
What, no chicks, no beer?
Oh, no, far from it. Actually, I watched an interesting documentary on the History Food Channel called Hitler's Secret Kitchen.
Oh, that kind of TV's boring. I blocked those channels.
Are you kidding, Ken? It's food for the mind. As a matter of fact, I can't wait to try the Eva Braunschweiger.
Yeah, whatever. Let's go to the music. And fresh from their Behind the Beef Curtain tour, it's the most famous rock and roll band in the history of the universe. They must be tons of chicks. So give it up for P-Lander Z!
Thank you.
Happylander Z, that was a choice song about meat products that stir these loins. Now, let's go to our tiebreaker and find out who will win, the Greeks or the Geeks!
And first up for the Greeks, Robert Neville. Looks like he wasn't quite ready there.
You're on a toilet paper. I went big boy potty.
Let's go, Skidmark.
There he goes. Got his mouthpiece in, and he's off.
I hope he washed his hands.
I hope you're right, Ken. Oh, and he is down, and down quickly.
Loser!
And of course, there's a Greek letter, Lambda, who stands for loser. Let's take another look at that, Ken.
Yeah, look right here. Oh, man. He's going to contaminate the bong water.
I think you might be right, Ken. And as we watch those tear-stained cheeks walk off in disgrace, up for the Geeks is Word Triplet. He's a blue jean splicer from the University of Nebraska.
Looks like he's wearing one of his experiments now.
Right you are, Ken.
Oh! And he's down quickly. He just cracked his genetic code.
I think you might be right. Let's take another look. Starts off alternating his X and Y. Oh, but he's got an extra chromosome. And
he goes downs. This guy's a total DNA hole.
Right you are, Ken. So our runoff has run out. Neither team scored, and we are still tied up 3-3.
Stay tuned as the Almost Live show continues with the battle of the MXC average students.
See what I did there.
From sunny Orlando, Florida, MXC Almost Live is back as America's future brain trust show us their tenacity and intellectual prowessness.
Okay, we're still tied up at 3-3.
Hey, Vic, I'm thinking about going back to school. Uh-huh. I'm only like 800 credits short of a degree. You think I'm crazy?
No, of course not. Aim high, my friend.
Aim high. Air Force.
So, Kenny, what's your major? What are you going to study?
I don't know. I only took one class, lesbian studies.
Ah, good place to start. I envy you, my friend. College life, study sessions, lively debate, lecture halls.
Whoa. What are you talking about, lecture halls?
Yes, term papers, lab reports. Ooh, thesis, Ken.
No, I'm talking about college, parties with chicks and beer.
Of course. It's time for window pane. Our contestants grip the dangling cable, swing across the mystery fluid, and press themselves firmly against the glass.
Yeah, like a bug on a windshield.
Indeed. Now let's go down to Greek Captain Tara Dakides.
So, once again, we got to show those geeks who can stick on that wall the best, right?
Well, it looks like the Greek team is ready. And first up for the geeks is Tammy Robbins.
You know,
they distribute wealth, but not mine.
Geek pride.
She's a senior from the Susan Sarandon School of Fashionable Liberal Studies. There she goes. She's off. And she sticks it, Ken. Chalk one up for the geeks. Looking right there, a nice lefty lunge into a Barney Frank, and she holds fast.
And she flip-flops and peels off right onto her back.
Next up, Lou Anderson.
I date women to fool my parents.
Lou's from I Jamma Manna, the gay fraternity study group.
Yeah, they help each other cram.
Let's see how he does here.
Here goes. Oh, he goes down.
Right you are, Ken. Let's take another look. You can see there, face down into the mattress.
I bet he's used to that.
I bet you might be right. Next up from Madison, Wisconsin, it's party schooler Ralph Turin. Hey. I swear, officer, I'll lick two beers. Ralph's the vomitorium attendant for Alpha Upa Chica.
I party with those guys. They're awesome pukers. They got volume and distance.
Good to know, Ken. Let's see what he does here. Oh, he had the volume and the distance, but he can't make it work, Ken. What a shame. That's going to hurt the Greeks. Let's take another look. Take us through the replay.
Oh, right here, he does a horizontal hurler into a reverse Ralpher. Throw some sawdust on him, he's done.
Right you are, Ken. And coming up, once again, it's hemorrhoidal studies major Jim Salim.
I have my own salt lick.
He looks puffy and inflamed.
Right you are, Ken, as he holds on to the ropey strand, which, of course, is a 3,000-pound Norwegian whaling line. And roll down into the fluid, Ken.
Man.
Let's take another look. Right there, his girthy little grip couldn't hang on. The book snaps up into the atmosphere.
And he's down straight into the fluid, provided by Hot Carl's RV Park Blue Water Dump Station.
Right you are, Ken. And now let's go down to Gimp and find out more about this big man with the little hearts.
How did you train for this event?
Oh, I've been starving myself. I am so hungry. I'll eat anything. Oh, I like this chocolate here. Look at this down here. That's not chocolate. That's really not chocolate.
Here's Richard Ratchet.
Turn your head and cough on this.
Interesting. Go.
Richard, of course, in a male nursing fraternity that specializes in the care of hazing victims.
I wouldn't want to be nursed by a male.
Right, you are. It looks like he's going to need some critical care right there, Ken. Let's take another look at that on replay. You can see Richard starts off with a 360 hot lift tool hand into a Florence Nightingale. Right there, he's triaged into an unwilling HMO. Next, from Columbia University, it's Bernie Bunsen.
How are you? I drive a Vespa!
Yeah. Okay.
Bernie's a chemistry major who's getting his PhD in PCP.
Even though he failed meth lab.
Oh, he's failed window pane as well.
Next up from Iceland is Oops Splugensen.
I like it cold.
There he is. Oops, of course, an ice shanty architectural student.
So he works with a lot of ice holes?
Bet you are, Ken.
Oh! Oh, and look at that!
Wow, I hope they beat that out, Ken. You hate to hear that kind of language. There he is on the replay, a hanging Helsinki into a flying Reykjavik. Still to no avail.
Five, six, seven,
and here's Don Merrick.
Turn.
My dance belt is really riding up on me. Dan's a male dance major from Tommy Toon Tech, specializing in feminine movement.
You mean like girly growlers?
Right you are, Ken. Oh, and look at that. And that, my friend, is our MXC Impact Replay.
Damn.
Let's take another look.
Yeah, right here, Vic. He starts with a girly swirly into a lilting floater, ending with a big interpretive dump.
His bowl could definitely use a little tidying, Ken.
Uh-huh.
And moving on to the man known as the Lemon-Scented Pledge, self-styled fraternity playboy and virgin, Rock Lang.
You know what? You show me your sword, I'll show you mine.
Yeah, he holds the record for lying about scoring with the most chicks.
Like Gerard, Ken, he is all talk, but no cow. Look at that, Ken!
Oh, he finally nailed something. Let's see that again.
Mike Girard, can take us through the replay, if you would.
Well, he starts out gently by caressing the ropey strand, then notices subtle romantic approach. Then he presses himself firmly between the pink curtains.
Oh,
I think he's in love.
And here's Ben Winkleman, a sleeping disorder major, suffering from narcolepsy and night terrors.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
Let's see what he can do here.
Oh!
Full sleep.
Uh-huh. I'm awake. No, I'm awake.
Let's take another look.
Yeah, right here, he goes into a sit and sleep and finishes up on a stained mattress. Nothing like the aroma of hot, brewing blue sewage to wake you up in the morning, Havoc.
Indeed. Here's Jackie Daniels, president of Delta Upsilon Iota, or DY.
You need at least some 0.08 grade point average to get in.
Right you are, Ken. Oh! And he is down. Let's take another look at that.
Look right here. He's blaming someone else for his problems.
Right you are, Ken. Let's take another look at that.
Keys.
From the highway patrol dashboard cam. Starts with a 12-step breathalyzer. Into a field sobriety checkpoint. Oh! And into the proverbial drink. Here's Levy Howell.
Who wants to see my little buddy?
Levy is taking Uncharted Island Studies, taught by Professor Anne Marianne.
It was supposed to be just a 3-hour class.
Right you are. Looks like she's landed on a coconut ping pong. Here's Chip Babaganoush.
If you join our fraternity, you'll get 19 virgin little sisters.
Mm-hmm. He, of course, the martyr rush chairman of Lambda Tau Head.
Wow, 19 virgins. That sounds good.
Indeed it does, Ken. And it looks like he's got a good run there. A dirty mosque into a marching mecca, and he sticks it, Ken. And that does it. The Greeks score twice, and the Geeks score once. So the score is now 5-4 with the Greeks in the lead.
Minor setback. Everything's under control. It's cool. It's cool. We got it. Geeks.
Hey, Vic.
Yes, Ken?
I just got accepted into Wellesley.
What? Kenny, that's an all-girls campus.
Yeah, I know. I'm in the sorority, too. I hope my roommate's hot.
When MXC Almost Live returns, will enrollment drop? We sure hope so. MXC Almost Live is back in session from Orlando, Florida, as our Greeks and Geeks flex their muscles and really shake things up.
And there you see, Ken, some of our young collegians lined up for the time-honored college tradition of selling bodily fluids for weekend beer money.
Wow, the guy with the horse is going to be a millionaire.
Right you are, Ken. Something unseemly has come to my attention, and I'd like to talk with you, Ken.
Not so loud. I got a hangover.
I know, Ken. I got a call from several local college administrators, and apparently you made the rounds to several parties last night, and you got a little out of hand.
Yeah. Kenny? Yeah, they ran out of cups, so I had to drink right out of the keg.
Kenny, I remind you, you're a broadcast professional and a representative of this show.
Yeah, I had to get the last drop.
It's time for Luck Drop.
And today's mystery fluid is stomach pump bilge water from the University of Central Florida Student Clinic.
Now let's go to Geek Team Captain Tony Hawk, who's discussing Luck Drop strategy with his team.
Stay dry? Good. Get wet? Bad. Repeat after me.
Stay dry, good. Get wet, bad.
One more time.
Stay dry, good. Get wet, bad.
Damn, these games are so dangerous, I'm wearing a cup.
Indeed. First up from the astronaut fraternity Alpha Gamma Ray, ready for liftoff. That's Lance Gordon. He's majoring in re-entry and claims to have a Deep Space Nine.
I wonder if he's ever been lunar probed.
Good question, Ken. There he is, whipping across nicely. Oh, and look at that. He has crashed and burned. Let's take another look at that on replay.
He starts off with a hobbling hubble into a crab nebula, then reverses his thrusters and is sucked into the black hole of loserness.
Indeed. Next up, Tad Tripe and his performance art life partner, Dennis Wank.
I could pee in a cup.
I could pee in a cup.
Ah, we could pee in a cup together.
That's art.
They both attend Cal Arts and Crafts, where they're majoring in macaroni collage and origami.
I learned that in summer camp.
Good to know. Now, in order to score, Tad and Dennis have both got to go all the way together.
Well, that's easy. They do that all the time.
Right you are. Oh, but it looks like they're not going to do it this time. Tad is already down, but Dennis makes it. However, it will not count. And it looks like Dennis is going to go back for his fallen comrade. I have never witnessed a more touching moment in sports, Dennis.
Are you crying?
Not necessarily. We had a chance to chat with this dynamic design duo earlier, and here's the inspirational message they shared.
Don't smoke crack.
Don't smoke cigarettes.
Don't smoke pot.
But you can smoke meat.
Words to live by, Ken, and here they are, of course, repeatedly paying tribute to their team captain, Tony Hawk.
Mine's a terrible thing to waste.
That, of course, Marcel Bundy.
Oh, Vicky ripped his face off.
Right you are, Ken, our favorite serial mimer, now going faceless across the logs.
Oh, hey, Vic.
Having a little trouble there.
When a mine falls and no one cares, does it hurt?
Well, that backbreaking sound sounded real enough to me. Let's take another look at the replay, Ken.
Yeah, he didn't know where to look. He's got his face in his right hand. Right now, he's miming a lumberjack, playing with his log. And now he should just hide his face in shame, like in his pocket or something.
Right you are, Ken. Coming up next is Irwin Corwin.
I'll tell you about anything on Animal Planet.
He, of course, is the president of the Campus Crocodile Hunter Club.
Look, he's holding the head of his spinning cobra.
Right you are, Ken. It looks freshly choked. Let's see what he does here. Oh, and Irwin's down. The endangered species list.
I hope he didn't hurt his ass.
Right you are, Ken. That's a tough one for the geeks as Tony Hawk looks on. Let's take a look at the replay. You can see right off, he starts with a skittering wallaby into a jumping jackaroo. And right here, he just misses a dirty marsupial, and he is down to the billabong. Next for the Greeks, Halston Ford.
Pink's the new black.
He's a member of Delta Versace Mizrahi Epsilon, a hot couture fraternity out of South Beach.
Cool toga, Vic.
Right you are, Ken. He's wearing a lovely one-piece polyester silk blend with a taffeta sash, making it perfect for daytime or evening beer batching.
Oh,
and he is into the drink. Too bad for Halston. And too bad for the Greeks. Let's take another look there. You can see that hemline is what's giving him trouble, Ken.
Yeah, he should have gathered it at the waist or maybe basted the seam before he darted it.
Right you are. Or, you know, a smart cleat now and again is always a good idea. Next up, Josh Miller.
This is in double time.
He's a second string drum major for the Stanford Marching Band.
Look, his string is hanging out.
Right you are, Ken. Josh's lifelong dream to play a strap-on organ. Oh, but look at that. He's achieved another dream right there. Let's take another look.
You know, Vic, I don't think I've ever seen anything so hideous.
Well, it's not the greatest log drop technique, Cam, but I've seen worse.
No, I think he wipes sideways.
Here's Aries Butkus.
Try to get your balls through these uprights, huh?
He, of course, a linebacker from San Francisco College. We had a chance to chat with him earlier.
My job as a middle linebacker is to fill the hole. I'll take down 10, 12 guys in a game. I'll take them down hard, too.
Harry, of course, led the conference for piling on and inappropriate contact after the whistle. He's gone down hard there, Ken. Let's take another look.
This guy is totally tough, Dick.
Indeed.
I mean, look at those glutes. His pecs are gigantic. This guy is a stud. I'd hate to go nose-to-nose with him.
Next up, death row inmate Riley Shetani.
Degrees open doors.
California is subsidizing his college education.
He's graduating in June, and he's lethally injected in July.
The important thing is to promise his mommy graduate. He is down there, Ken. That's no good for the geeks. Let's take another look on replay here. Starting out with a flailing bunk buddy into a solitary confinement. And ending up right there with a parole violation.
Here's my USB port.
And from the Stepford sorority, here's freshman Dunka Boatman.
Yeah, she's that fourth triplet I was with last night.
Well, it looks like she just might go all the way, Ken.
No, she doesn't, but her sisters do.
Good to know. There she is struggling there on that last log, and she makes it.
Oh.
Dunka Boatman scores another one for the Greeks. Next up, Jolly North.
War! Right now!
He is a student pro-war activist.
Yeah, G organized a one-man march in Washington to support world conflict in all its form.
Right, you are, Ken. Oh, and that is our MXC Impact replay. You can see he starts out with a covert insertion, then into a cowering peacekeeper, and throws himself into the breach.
I think he just fell because he's fat.
Next up, Punjabi Johnson.
This is my stink finger.
He's from the Sigma Calcutta fraternity in New Delhi.
I like the old Delhi better. They have better sandwiches.
Good to know, Ken. And there's Punjabi moving nicely across those lines. And he's scored for the Greeks.
Look, he's on the warpath, Vic.
Wrong kind of Indian, Ken. Next up, Helen Horn from Johns Hopkins University.
Yeah, I take temperatures the hard way.
She's a nursing home management major with a minor in waterless bathing techniques.
Yeah, Nana Blankenship gets those dry baths twice a week, but she still smells like vomit and onions.
Good to know, Ken. And let's see what Helen does here. She skitters across there, and she scores another one for the geeks.
Wow, she must have really strong arms.
I think you're right, Ken. Next up, Jeremy Fine.
We're Delta Tau. We're born to prank.
He's a weekend Delta Tau warrior.
Yeah, he holds the record for clogging toilets and short-sheeting beds.
Gerard Campbell. Oh, he now holds the record for multiple cranial fractures. Let's take another look.
Well, here's the problem right here, Vic. He slips, and then he hits his head. If he didn't do that, he would have won.
Great insight as always, Ken. Next up, journalism student Ann Oldenburg.
I like colorful newspapers.
She's majoring in plagiarism with a minor in fabricated research.
Yeah, she's already been offered a job at the Times.
Good for her. Let's see how she does here. Looks like time might be running out for Ann, and she is down and down hard. Let's take another look.
Wow, if she keeps this up, she's going to have to plagiarize somebody else's obituary.
Right you are, Ken. Next up for the Greeks, Lisa Kanker.
I'm almost disease-free.
She's a member of Sigma Tau Delta, STD, the new sorority that's spreading across colleges all over the country, Ken. Oh!
Yeah, there's legions of them everywhere.
Didn't you mean legions, Ken?
No.
Well, she's going to need a topical cream for that run.
Sorry about your water.
And last up for the Geeks, the blue veiner, Hank Abagnale.
If I make this, perhaps people will like me and I will no longer be ostracized.
He spoke with Gip earlier.
Nobody likes me.
Hank, of course, has got a BA, a BFA, and an MBA, and everyone knows it was all BS, but his response was BFD.
Now he works for the VA.
And he's also worked himself into a win, and he has tied this up for the Geeks. He's brought the back. Unbelievable, Ken. The blue veiner has tied it up.
I like myself.
Geeks have scored thrice, while the Greeks only twice, and now our game is tied up at 7-7.
Wow, it's tie. How'd that happen?
Well, seven players on one team made it, and then
almost
course,
as what?
What?
Stay tuned as the Birdman takes on the Terrorizer. MXC Almost Live is back from Orlando, Florida, for the final battle of the Party Maniacs versus the Classroom Brainiacs.
Exciting conclusion, Ken. We've ended in a tie.
Yeah. Who won?
Kenny, it's a tie. Back and forth.
Oh, yeah.
Look, try to stay focused, will you?
Yeah, I'm still a little hungover.
Yeah, it seems like it. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, look at the vomit on my shoes.
Ooh, rather not.
Oh, it ended in a tie. Kiss each other open mouth for congratulations.
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. Isn't there, like, sudden death? Or it can't end on a tie.
Well, there you heard it, Ken. Tara and Tony are not going to let this thing end in a tie. And you can see both teams, we've got kind of a melee going down there. Hoping to get some security. Things really getting out of hand.
Yeah, they should kill each other. Yeah.
Well, as much as I enjoy a good Donnybrook now and then, it just isn't the way to settle this, Ken.
Oh, come on, Vic.
No, we're having a tiebreaker, and the Birdman is ready to go. So let's go to Tony Hawk.
All right.
And there he is in position, the king of the geeks. And you can see why. Clearly not the body of a trained athlete.
Yeah, let's see how he does without wheels under his feet.
Right you are. Very gangly, jerky movements. I don't know if he can make it, Ken, but he does!
Oh,
unbelievable! Tony Hawk puts the geeks in the lead. Let's take a look at that run. He starts with a kickflip, a pop shove it into a K-grind, a 50-50 tail slide, and a crooked ollie grind.
That was awesome.
Indeed it was, Ken.
Oh, man.
And you can see Tony's team is geeking out all over him.
They're touching each other.
Right you are. Well, it's all up to Tara. She is the last chance for the Greeks. Let's see if she can do it. The cocky Tony Hawk.
She can do it. She's hot.
In position. And she takes off, Ken. Right into a melancholy. A mute grab. An indie grab to a snail fish. Tara Dakides does it for the Greeks. She ties it up. Unbelievable.
She is hot.
Her team now charging the long.
Underwear.
All I see is a scoreboard for the first annual MXC Almost Live special. It ends in a tie. Greeks 8, Geeks 8.
Rematch? Do you mean it?
Yes.
Yeah, I want a rematch.
I want a rematch for sure.
This could be huge.
Wow, great stuff, Ken.
Yeah. Hey, did you see that birthmark on Tara's back? That was hot.
So is our first MXC Almost Live special. Hey, Tony, you and your friends want to get away from the car? Thanks.
Hey, let's do the top 10, Vic.
Oh, yeah. Let's do
it now. Come on.
Okay, we will. Just a second. And, Tony, seriously, get the skateboard away from the Matador, please.
Nah, it's okay. They're just grinding. Let's do the top 10.
It's time for Kenny Blankenship's painful eliminations of the day.
Man, blasting off at number 10, it's Jim Zelin, who should have studied physics. Weight times mass times gravitational pull equals tidal wave. At number 9, it's Lino Higby, who bangs her bearded shillelagh and gets potato pancakes. Look at those doughy mouths. And bouncing at number 8 is Carnegie Mellon's Kimber Swallows, who could take up two spots in this countdown. She's a dirty girl.
And number seven goes to drum major Josh Miller. He moves the entire percussion and wind section across the logs. And number six goes to Benny Ford, who ought to work for the Postal Service. Look at his mailbag. He took a thong turn. And number five goes to dance student Don Merrick. He takes one bad box step, slips his disco into a septic samba. And checking in at number four is war activist Jolly North. He calls for an airstrike, falls flat in his demilitarized zone, and tanks it. And number three goes to Golden Glove champ Gary Schultz. He starts out dancing, takes a dive, and goes down for the count. Who's the count? And number two appropriately goes to frat house toilet clogger Jeremy Fine. I think he pinched off more than he could chew. And my most painful elimination of the day goes to road trip scholar Matt Hayden. This crash test dummy took a wrong turn and had a head-on collision with a solid oak door. One-way trip to the emergency room.
Oh, Kenny, that was great, wasn't it?
Great show, huh, Vic?
Indeed it was, and we want to give a big thank you to the city of Orlando for having us.
Yeah, I still got a headache, though. Where can I get a beer around here?
Well, I don't know, Ken, but while you're trying to figure that out, let me thank Tony Hawk, Tara Dakides, P-Lander Z, and remember, kids, what do we always say?
Don't get free!
She is hot.